Hi everyone, it's Lindsay and I'm here today to share with you making a card inside and out. That's something I've gotten into lately, is really decorating the inside of my cards just as much as I do the outside. So I am using this freebie from Craft No Desert Divas. It is free during the Coffee Lovers Blog Hop, and this digital stamp is called Coffee Love. Be sure to head over to the Craft and Desert Divas blog. There you'll find all the information on how you can snag this while it's available. I'm using the Fancy Frames die just to go ahead and die cut that out. Then I'll be using my alcohol markers to color this in. So a little information on the digital stamps. I always like to use Photoshop Elements whenever I open mine, and then I go in and I resize them and I print them off with my laser printer. I normally print with crop marks like I did this time. I didn't end up using them here. I just went ahead and die cut the image out, but I like that option in case I just want to trim out a panel with my paper trimmer. Now I also print with my laser printer like I said before. This allows me to color with my alcohol markers if I wanted to do colored pencils or Gamsol, and I know it's not going to smear on me, and that's why I like my laser printer so much. It also allows my kids to print as much as they want, and I don't have to go buy ink every other week. So that's another reason that I love it. Now I am using just a few different colors here. I use some blonde on the little girl's hair. I use some browns on the little boy's hair. I use the same colors of skin tones for each, the boy and the girl. For the little girl, I'm giving her a red and black sort of outfit here. And then for the little boy, I'm going to give him some blue jeans. And then I'm also going to give him a black shirt. Now, whenever I color with my black, I do have to be a little bit careful on very small detailed images like this because it does tend to bleed. So I just kind of stay away from the lines, let it bleed out, and then it fills in the image on its own. I colored in his shoes with some blacks. I colored in the little heart with some red. And then for the cups, both in their hands and that they're sitting on, I'm using some cream colors here. I wanted this image to be a little muted. I wanted the little kids to stand out from the cups, so I kept those very, very simple. Now, whenever I am masking off my digital images, first of all, if there's even a chance that I'm going to be masking off, while I have my document open, I go ahead and print the same exact panel onto just plain computer paper. Now this allows me to go in and fussy cut out those images like I did here. I even separated these two so they would be a little bit easier to place down. Then I grab out my rubber cement. This is just the rubber cement that you find for like $2 in the kids aisle at whatever store you might be in. Craft stores, grocery stores even have this. Very easy to find. I put a very thin layer right on the back, and I use the brush that's in the bottle. You can use an old paintbrush if you want to, but I find the brush in the bottle works just fine for me. Then I go ahead and place this right over the top of it. You do want to be a little bit careful. You do have a little bit of play time, but anywhere that that rubber cement seeps out, it's going to mask off the image. So you just need to be a little bit more careful when placing this down, but I will show you how to fix it if you do have any mistakes or any seepage. I went ahead and masked off all the images in the same exact way, including the heart. Then I cut another piece of computer paper with the largest circle in the Inside Scallop Circles die set from Craft and Desert Divas. I'm going to use this as a mask for kind of to create a little circle scene here. I grabbed out some mowed lawn. I've got a scrap piece of cardstock here that I'm using as a horizon line. I just wanted a straight line, very simple. You could also use a grass border if you wanted to. That would be really cute. I put a little bit of mowed lawn right down at the bottom with my mini ink blending tool. And then I'm going to go ahead and use some salty ocean for the sky. I should also mention I did give like a minute for my rubber cement to dry, for my mask to dry down. It literally only takes a minute, if that, when you're using a very thin layer. It dries instantly almost. So I went ahead and used that salty ocean just to give a nice sky effect. And you also can't see it right now, but I do have that circle mask taped down just on the back so it doesn't get in my way at all. And that way it stays put on that cardstock and I don't have to mess around with it at all. I'm just going to go ahead and quickly go around the circle so I get a nice defined edge. I'm leaving the center of this a little bit lighter, which is a different sort of way to put on my ink. Normally I go from either the bottom up or the top down, but this time I'm going from all edges to the center for a lighter effect. Now I'm going to go ahead and peel up these masks, and there you can see I've got a nice circle scene sort of sketched out there. Peel off this painter's tape. This is my favorite part, is the reveal, so I left all of it in there. Then I'll flip it back over and I'll start to take off these masks. Now these remove very easily, just peel them up. You can see there is no damage to the coloring behind it. The rubber cement doesn't do any damage at all. You might find that you have a little bit of a sort of residue over your images, but all you need to do is take your finger, like I'm doing here, rub over the images, and it balls up. Now, if you have any distressing sort of around it, go ahead and use a paper towel to do that so you don't smear your coloring. Now, you can see I did have a few little spaces where my rubber cement oozed out from behind the mask. That's okay. I use this little Fantastics tool, dip it in my ink, then I sort of scribble that ink off onto a scrap piece of cardstock. And when I have just the tiniest bit left on, I come back and buff it over those white edges, and that's going to take away most of that white edge. It's not going to be perfect, but it's a handmade card. It doesn't need to be 100% perfect. There you can see that little image all ready to go, and now onto the sentiment. Now, because I had my entire panel already ready to go on my card, and if there's a chance that I'm going to mess it up, I'll mess it up. Since it was completely done, I went ahead and pulled out my mini Misty, and I'm going to use the Wishful Thoughts to stamp on a sentiment. So I've got this large scripty Wishing You sentiment. I'm going to stamp it starting in the left-hand corner, heading to the right side in black dye ink. Now, because I'm using my mini Misty, I can go ahead and give this a couple stamps. I know it's going to line directly up, and I'm going to get a nice, bold, dark black sentiment that's going to stand out from that scene. Now, right underneath that, I'm going to go ahead and place the "were here with me." So the sentiment will end up reading, "Wishing you were here with me." I thought it was the perfect little sentiment to go with this image. I'll place that down, pick it up with my lid, and then again, I'm going to give this a couple stamps with that same black dye ink. And this is just a nice little scripty sentiment that's going to go all the way across the top of the card and carry your eye all the way across the card too as well. And I did use black to kind of pull out the black in their outfits and also help it stand out from that scene as well. There's a nice close-up of the finished panel all ready to go on the card base. Now, before I added this to the front of my card, I am going to go ahead and stamp on the inside of my card. So from that same Wishful Thoughts stamp set, here's a peek at that. You can see it's got all of these great little sentiments that you can build up to create your own custom sentiment. So I'm going to use my mini Misty again. And if you have a mini Misty, you can still stamp on the inside of your cards. Just go ahead and flip the front over towards the back, and then just put it in like you would any other card panel, and you can stamp on the inside of your card. So I went ahead and built up Sending Hugs to stamp on the inside. I'm going to just put it towards the top in the center, and I can use my grid to go ahead and make sure everything's nice and straight. I just needed to adjust that Hugs just a little bit. And then I'm going to use, again, the same black dye ink to go ahead and stamp this down, and I'm using my Misty, so I am going to give it a few stamps. Now, something that I have been getting into is decorating the inside of my cards, like I said before. I had trouble with this before because, especially with my digital images, because I wanted the inside to be very matchy-matchy with the front. But then I thought, you know, why does it have to be? So as long as you're carrying kind of the same color scheme or the same tone, so this is a very cute card, so I'm going to make the card very cute and carry the same color tone across to the inside to decorate the inside. Now, these are just die cuts that I had from a card before. I didn't end up using them on there, so I keep a little bowl on my desk just filled with all these random die cuts, and I was able to pull these out and make a little scene on the inside of my card. So these are all from the Scene Builders die set. And I'm first starting out with the top of the tree, and this is die cut just from some green polka dot pattern paper, which I thought was really fun to do. Sort of different instead of just your plain green. Then I'll go ahead and put the base of the tree, which is just cut from some brown cardstock, right down on top of that, so the little branches are kind of on top of the tree, so you get a nice view of those. Now above that, I'm going to go ahead and put a cloud and a sun. I want the sun peeking out from behind the cloud, so I did attach the sun to the cloud first, and then I'll go ahead and attach both just right underneath that S. It's going to hang over the tree a little bit, but that's okay. It kind of looks more cohesive that way. Then, to carry this scene all the way across the inside of the card, I'm going to take this little black bird and put it right in the top right-hand corner to complete the entire card inside and out. I hope you guys enjoyed this video tutorial. Remember to head over to the Craft and Desert Divas blog to see how you can pick up this digital stamp for free. And as always, I'm going to leave you guys with this close-up and a few pictures of the finished card. On the left side of your screen, you're going to see a few different links you can click on. The top will take you to a video you might enjoy watching next. The bottom left will take you to the supply list for this card, and the bottom right will subscribe you to my channel. Thank you guys so much for watching today, and happy crafting!